Why did you do it? Harvey needed you. Why save me?
I haven't actually seen it yet. They've had me wrapped up this whole time. Numbed beyond belief. Maybe it's not that bad.
Our stock is tanking. The board is losing confidence. Wayne Enterprises needs a new face. Oswald Cobblepot.
You're the only ally I have in this building. It's important. I need you to be my eyes and ears.
All right, I can do that.
Keep Oswald out of R&D, and let me know if anything comes up.
You're good now, Bruce.
I think you may have misinterpreted things.
Oh. Sorry.
Please, Selina, I have to tell you how I...
Bruce?
You should come stay with me.
I'll think about it.
Dropped your pen.
It's not...
I think it's time you knew my real name. I am Lady Arkham.
You have to face the truth sometime.
Retribution, Bruce.
Okay, I'm up.
For Christ's sake, put some clothes on. Doctor's making the rounds soon.
Doctor? What doctor? Is that my blood? God, I hope it's mine. Someone was angry. Lovely. Arkham Asylum. This can't be happening. This can't be real.
Better be decent.
You settled? Good. Anything you need? Water? Piss? Rat poison? I've been asked for rope before. Not really allowed to give it out. Of course, I could make an exception for you.
You can tell me why I'm in Arkham Asylum for a start.
What? Rich boy doesn't remember? Oswald Cobblepot? You beat him to a bloody pulp. Nearly killed him. Landed you here. Any of this ringing a bell? Might as well get comfortable. This is your home now. Time to meet your neighbors. As you were.
You look just like him. Your father ever tell you about me? How he sent me here? Left me to rot in this goddamn hellhole? Somebody's gotta pay for that. I hope to God there is a hell.
I am so sick of everyone blaming me for what my father did. I'm not him. Hurting me does nothing.
Maybe not, but you're the next best thing, Wayne.
Does it look like I'm okay?
Not one bit.
What is going on in here?
It's like I told you, Doctor. These creeps were attacking the new guy.
Well, who did that? Was it you?
Of course not. It was mostly over by the time I got in. The new guy's tougher than he looks. Right, buddy?
Bruce, is that really what happened?
Go on, tell her.
Yeah, that's what happened.
We have a very strict no-fighting policy here in Arkham. If you can't obey that rule, you're going to find yourself in hot water fast.
The orderly that was here before took money from these men and let them into my room. He gave them a taser.
I knew that you coming to Arkham could cause some excitement, but I didn't expect it to happen so fast. I'll do my best to keep you safe. But I need you to be careful.
Us nice guys gotta stick together. Am I right?
Safe. And how do you plan to do that?
You're hardly the first patient in Arkham Asylum to be attacked. I'm sure we can figure something out. I'm Dr. Joan Leland, by the way, head of psychiatry. I'll be overseeing your case personally. We'll get you transferred to a new room, Bruce. One that doesn't have your blood all over it. For now, follow me.
I'm sorry, I don't think I ever got your name.
Me?
He's never given his name out to anybody.
What?
We just call him John Doe.
Bingo.
John is one of our most improved patients. He's been with us for quite some time. I'm sure he'd be willing to show you around. Right, John?
Oh, yeah. I'll show him the whole nine yards.
I think it would be best if you stayed by his side.
There's not enough black tiles, you hear me? There's too many white tiles!
Our last session was so enlightening.
That's good to hear. Your next evaluation is in a few weeks. I'm glad you're starting to understand yourself better.
Oh, every day, Doctor.
Every day.
I can't taste anything! I want a taste!
You gotta be more careful, Bruce. Some of these guys bite. remember the first time you let me into the rec room, Dr. Leland?
How could I forget?
You had to teach me how to play checkers.
Yes.
No! No! You need to let me go! I have to warn the president! You're trying to kill me!
You don't know the president.
They don't like it when you try to use the phone.
That's because phones are for staff use only. No exceptions.
Then stop that guy from trying. Such persistence.
Wrong number, Dimash!
Stop! I'll come by to check on you two later.
Don't worry about us, Dr. Leland. I'm gonna take good care of him.
Welcome to Arkham Asylum!
Believe it or not, some of these people are crazy. But everyone's friendly, mostly. I'd watch yourself around those two. Not a big fan of strangers. And just a little bit, you know, prone to outbursts of violence.
What did they do?
This is Arkham, Bruce! Use that sick little imagination of yours. Murder, mayhem, carnage, the usual. Let's see. On the couch, that's St. Louis. Ooh, shh. His favorite show's on. Never misses it. All right, friendo. Commercial break. Get up! Where is the remote? One of the orderlies must have taken it. Never fear, though. I'll go ask Leland. She likes me. Ooh! I almost forgot. Here.
What is this?
You got a bad case of the mind knives. I can tell. I can tell. Just shove off, all right? No mind knives for me. I already got my shots.
If that's the way the cookie crumbles... Cookie... Cookie crumbs! That's it! Yes!
Not the right key for this.
Hey, I was wondering about...
It's not lunch yet.
Well, actually,
and
I wasn't...
it's not time for meds either. Beat it.
I solved the cookie riddle, not you.
Sorry. Sorry, it's his voice! It's driving me nuts!
Oh, but you're already nuts, aren't you?
Bruce Wayne, you've got quite a reputation around here. Taking your enemies out to stay on top. I like your style, kid.
Guy I walked in here with, what can you tell me about him?
John Doe? A lot of folks are scared of him.
Yeah? Why is that?
Same reason folks are scared of tornadoes. They're chaotic. Unpredictable. I'm speaking as a professional. I find his work a bit sloppy. But he's certainly enthusiastic. I'll give him that much.
Hey there, buddy boy. You miss me? I missed you.
However, the threat remains. The children of Arkham are still out there, and I will not rest until these streets are safe and firmly under my control.
And never anything good on, is there?
He cheats. Every time, he cheats! Sees what I'm thinking. Mind control! Cheater!
I told you. If I could read minds, I certainly wouldn't waste my time on yours.
Wait, that's the move you're going to make?
Huh?
Yeah.
Why?
Why? No reason. No reason.
Sorry, I can't talk right now. I gotta keep my eye on this guy.
Lewis!
That wasn't me. I'm sane, Lewis. And that was... that was crazy, Lewis. You see?
Hello?
Hello?
Go away! Arnold's busy. I swear, if you bother him, I will gut you.
What can you tell me about, John Doe?
John? Nothing. I don't know anything. John? Ah, I love that guy. Makes me laugh. Want to know something weird? No one remembers the day John came to Arkham. Not even the doctors. They don't have any record of him ever being committed. You'd think a freak with green hair would be pretty goddamn memorable, right? But yeah, nothing.
What's that? Not polite at all. At all.
I'm not really crazy, you know, in case you were wondering.
Well, don't worry. I'm not crazy either.
Yeah, right. You wouldn't be here if you weren't.
Sure. There. Your key? It didn't work.
Of course not. That's not how you get out of here.
You tried it though, didn't you? That's hilarious.
My enforcement squad has already seen great success. They stopped a massive attack being organized out of a local SkyTrain depot.
Politicians usually bore me to tears, but this one has become a lot more interesting lately.
In my Gotham, no one's above the law, including Bruce Wayne. After his vicious attack on Oswald Cobblepot, I had Mr. Wayne committed to Arkham Asylum, where I hope he'll receive the treatment he so desperately needs.
Double-crossing, two-faced. I thought you and the mayor were friends. I mean, you were supporting his campaign. I saw all sorts of photos of the two of you together.
He is the reason I am in here. I can't believe he did this.
Quite the temper on you. I have one too.
In which Mayor Dent announced the creation of a special enforcement squad under his direct command to combat an imminent threat from the children of Arkham.
Rest assured, we will find these terrorists, their stockpile of drugs, and their leader, this Lady Arkham, before they can strike again.
Now, this is good television! Mayor on a rampage versus freaky drug terrorist.
I'm gonna find your drugs.
I'm going to expose your corruption.
Harvey is going way too far.
You think so? I can't wait to see where he goes next!
Tragically, there's still no sign of Gotham Gazette reporter Vicki Vale after her mysterious disappearance earlier this week.
Very tricky, Vicki. I think we both know she's quite the lady, right, Bruce?
Wait, you know that Vicki is... Tell me what you know.
You want to find Vicki and her drugs, huh? Get your revenge just like you got your revenge on Cobblepot? Publicly and dramatically, something entertaining for these newscasters to talk about.
I'll find a way to take her down, but I'm doing it my way, quietly.
Could be interesting. Little Bruce
lurking in the shadows.
Though I think we both know you could do more. I've been watching you for a while now, Bruce, and I can tell there's something darker in you. When you attacked Oswald, I could tell you enjoyed it. If those cops hadn't dragged you off of him, that Cobblepot punk would be dead.
After everything Oswald has done to me, yeah, I'm kind of glad it happened, because he deserved it.
Am I glad to see you embracing those feelings? They're very natural. Especially a guy like you, who clearly takes after his father. It's obvious that's why Vicki hates you. Your dad helped bump off her parents!
Why would my father have the Vales killed?
I never said he killed the Vales. She was born in Arkham. Victoria Arkham.
What?
You didn't know that? The Arkhams did not approve of what your dad and his partners were doing. They were gonna blow the whistle on the whole thing, so your dad, well, pop, pop. Her parents murdered, leaving her with an unquenchable thirst for vengeance. Surely you can relate. Tragedy can drive people to do some pretty dark stuff.
Yeah, I can relate to that. Tragedy can be a powerful motivation.
I knew it. I knew it. Very good instincts on this sort of thing. You and Vicki are both dark souls, and now you're heading on a collision course towards each other. That's gonna be fantastic! You see, I know what you really are. And that's why I really want to tell you where Vicki's moved her drugs, but you're not gonna do anything while you're stuck in here. So, I vote we get you out. How hard can it be? You're Bruce Wayne. The Waynes always get what they want. All it would take is a phone call.
Well, sure, but there's no phone.
Assume I can take care of that. But it's gonna come at a price. When I get out of here, you're gonna owe me a favor. Okay? Just one. Yeah, I don't know what it is yet.
Sure. One favor, that seems fair.
Excellent. We'll have loads of fun. You'll see. All right, tell you what. I'm gonna make a distraction to get the guards away from that gate. The rest is up to you. You make that phone call, and I promise I'll tell you how to find those missing drugs. Hey! Zaz! Hello, Zaz.
What the hell do you want?
Settle a bet. What happens if you make a tally mark before you kill someone?
What are you talking about? Ah! No!
No, I don't match him.
Oh, God, I don't match!
You can fix that right now!
Skin feels like it's itching. Burning! Need to get rid of it! Stop! Someone get me a sedative!
Run, Brucey! Run!
Damn it! Call security!
Hello?
Alfred.
It's you, sir. It's so good to hear your voice. I've been trying to contact you, but they wouldn't let me through. They told me you'd lost your mind.
Contact my lawyers. You'll need to post bail, but that shouldn't be a problem. You have got to get me out of here.
I'll see what I can do.
I have to go.
Oh, Bruce, I have not had this much fun in ages.
Let me tell you how to find Vicky's stash of missing drugs. Ask the Veils.
Quickly, come on.
Look at the lock on the outside, Bruce. I just
know you're gonna put on quite a show.
Pretty grisly scene in there. Multiple stabbings. One of the orderlies had a finger bitten off.
If you're looking for who to blame, maybe start with the mirror, because you're the one that left violent psychotics unattended.
Mr. Wayne, I understand you have been through a trying day, but that does not give you the freedom to criticize me or this facility in that way. Because from my perspective, my patients were fine until you went into that rec room today. One moment. Seems you have a visitor.
Alfred.
Ah, Bruce. Thank heavens you're all right. You see, everything is in order. He is to be released into my care.
You may have the money to make this go away, but this is going to hurt you in the long run. What happened with those men in your room? The riot with Zaz? You clearly need help, Bruce. He needs extensive evaluation, treatment.
I think I'll get a second opinion.
Yeah. I'm sure you can afford the one you like.
Let's go, Alfred.
I will see you on the outside, Bruce.
I can't wait!
What's that about?
Well, I just can't believe that Lady Arkham was actually Vicky Vale this entire time.
And all the while she was working with Cobblepot to try and bring me down.
It's a good thing the family lawyers were able to get you out so quickly.
No kidding. Batman's got some work to do.
Even during Batman's brief hiatus, Gotham has become that much more dangerous. And the public opinion on Bruce Wayne... Well, it certainly hasn't gotten any better.
Yeah, well, that's why it's Batman's turn now.
True, I suppose public opinion doesn't affect him much. Though, if the people protesting to have you thrown back in Arkham get their way, that could put a damper on things.
Hello, Harvey.
You should have stayed in the asylum where I put you.
What do you want, Harvey?
The streets of Gotham are a dangerous place for someone like you right now. Well, you'll figure that out. eventually.
They're only dangerous because you made them dangerous. Armed guards on every street corner? It's insane, Harvey.
I beg to differ. With the children of Arkham sneaking around everywhere, those armed guards are the only thing keeping people safe. Maybe you haven't heard, but the children of Arkham have gone underground, obviously plotting some sort of attack, and people are scared, panicking. I needed to show them that my resolve hasn't weakened, that Gotham is still strong. So I gave them an enemy. You and your family's filthy corruption. The last thing I need is you traipsing around Gotham.
Harvey, how about we just agree to go our separate ways, all right?
You think you can just walk away from me? Just like that, after everything you've done? Can't let you keep running around scot-free, Bruce. It's the will of the people.
You can spare me your will of the people crap, Harvey. I know this is personal.
You knew I was interested in Selina. What you did was a low blow, Bruce. A real man wouldn't have done that. A friend wouldn't have done that.
You need to let that situation go, Harvey. You have way bigger problems on your plate.
Of course you would think that. Bruce? Bruce!
We're done talking. What's going on here?
Well, well, well. Bruce Wayne. You really must have done something to piss the mayor off so much, hmm? Maybe I'll get a bonus for this. Open the trunk. We're searching the car. Now, if we find anything tying you to the children of Arkham, including drugs, weapons, or any other suspicious materials, you will be taken into custody.
Like hell you are. The only way you're searching this car is with two broken arms afterwards.
Oh, I don't think that would be a good idea.
Come on, what's the damn holdup?
Get back to your car!
Of course. Should've known. Go back to Arkham, you damn maniac!
The hell?
Careful, or you'll be the next cobblepot.
Showing your face in public like this? Not real smart.
You can still leave, and I would take advantage of that while both your kneecaps are still attached correctly.
Someone else heard that, right? This psycho just threatened me!
Yeah, I filmed the whole thing!
They should lock you up!
Oh, God, Alfred, I'm sorry. I don't...
You'll be fine. We just need to get out of this mess.
Nowhere to run, dirtbag!
Next one won't be a warning shot!
All right, now the way I see it, there are two ways we can do this, Bruce Wayne. Either I let these people at you and see how you handle mob justice, or you could make a little donation to me and my boys to help us stay well-funded, hmm? And well-armed? What do you say?
They've got us blocked in. I can't back up. This is turning ugly, sir. What would you like to do?
Hey, the mayor's gonna hear about this, and it ain't gonna make him happy.
Ram the barricade!
This isn't the Batmobile.
Just do it, Alfred!
What do you mean you're leaving?
Bruce, Harvey's clearly lost it. All over the news yelling about how you need to be brought to justice, throwing whoever he wants in jail. Not really interested in seeing what he has planned for me. I was supposed to be here laying low. Does this look like laying low to you?
Funny, I thought you could handle yourself.
Oh, I can. I just also know when it's time to make myself scarce. Don't you get it, Bruce? Harvey catching you in my apartment drove him completely around the bend.
So you're saying you think his breakdown is our fault?
Yeah? Nothing even really happened.
Not like he thinks, anyway. I'd rather not die for something I didn't even do. He's dangerous. You understand, don't you?
Okay, don't you think you're being just a little overdramatic? Harvey wouldn't kill you.
No? Look what he's done to you. And you're the type of person who shows up in headlines. He could have me killed and no one would ever know.
So where are you gonna go?
We got some other business I need to take care of.
What other business?
Look at yourself, Bruce. You're in no shape to take on Harvey. Or the children of Arkham, for that matter. Of course. That's my car. See you around. Good luck with all of this.
To get to the computer.
You're exhausted. And the influence of Lady Arkham's drug may still be affecting you.
Harvey is turning Gotham into a police state. Oswald has stolen my company, and we need to find Vicky and the children of Arkham before they strike again. I can't just ignore it.
You're in no condition to work. You absolutely must get some rest.
Then help me. It feels like the whole damn cave is coming down around.
Of course I'll help. Let's start by addressing the problem at hand.
You're right. Let's just focus on getting my head clear first. Bring up everything we know about Vicky Vale's drug.
Yes, of course.
If I can isolate the presence of the drug, I should be able to synthesize an antidote. Start a DNA scan. Compare it to my DNA on file in the back computer.
I'll make the preparations.
This is the refined sample of the drug taken from Officer Montoya after she killed Falcone. Here's my DNA before the incident. Seems that the drug attaches itself to specific proteins in the genome structure. If we can modify the drug's molecular structure, we should be able to create a counteragent.
Once you've figured this out, we'll have a working antidote. We can cure others affected by the drug.
No. I wish that were possible. This cure is based on my DNA. It'll only work for me. To cure other people, we'd have to sample and decode the genome structure for each and every person to make them an antidote.
We don't have the time or resources for that.
That's why we were lucky to have mine on file already. Should do it. This needs to be injected directly into the vein to work.
I don't imagine it'll be much fun. Hopefully that does the trick.
It'll work, Alfred. Feel better already.
So, what are we going to do now?
First things first, I need to know what Vicky, Lady Arkham, has been up to while I've been away.
Search for all children of Arkham recent activity. The press is reporting that Vicky Vale is missing.
Yes, and obviously the police have yet to find a body.
That woman, trying to get the scoop on you, pretending to care. She betrayed you.
I never trusted her. It was always something off.
Your instincts are very rarely wrong, sir.
She was playing me the entire time, breaking me down. She wanted me in Arkham. She wanted me to feel what my father had done to all those people.
Bruce.
There were bigger plans than me, Alfred. Batman stopped her at the Skyrail station, and I can't believe that she isn't finding another way to use the drugs.
Well, if that's true, she may be more dangerous than ever.
I know. I met someone in Arkham who gave me a tip on how to find her.
A tip? Do you really think you can trust someone in Arkham Asylum? No offense intended toward your recent time there, of course.
No, I absolutely don't trust him. The man is psychotic.
Wonderful. Well, let's try to steer clear of him in the future, shall we?
He told me that if I want to know what she's planning, then I should visit her parents' house.
If the Vales still live in Gotham, they should be easy enough to locate.
Got it.
Bruce!
Yeah? If you do find Miss Vale, please, be careful.
I'm inside the Vale House. Alfred, the Vales are dead. One body confirmed, but there was a lot of blood. Alert Gordon.
Will do.
I don't know how this is connected to the drugs yet. Whatever they knew about it, Vicky made sure they kept quiet. Syringe. Seems she hasn't given up her old tricks.
Is this the same drug?
Yes. But this is several times stronger than the dosage I received.
Maybe she's escalating.
This seems personal. Her eyes are gone. Stabbed out.
That's disturbing.
There's an injection wound on her neck. Same kind Montoya and I both received, but this one's much worse. Same device, same drug. This confirms that Lady Arkham is the murderer.
Recent family photo?
Vicky's not in it. It shows the Vales with another child in front of an industrial office. There's a logo on the building. Large amounts of blood spatter across the walls. It's not steady like arterial spray. Someone was swinging wildly. Wait, there's a slight indentation where something bloody struck the wall with force.
Something thrown.
Nothing I can see. A found a lock of hair.
Anything unique about it?
It was cut at a downward angle, probably with some force based on how clean the slice is. It's clean. This wasn't used as a murder weapon.
Then why was it lying on the floor?
Alfred found Mr. Vale.
Alive?
No. He's gone. 10 hours at least, judging by the state of his soft tissues. Looks like a company logo. The belt buckle is covered in blood. Before he was hung with the belt, Mr. Vale was beaten with it. The indentation matches the shape of the belt buckle. It must have impacted with the wall during the attack. It appears Mrs. Vale attempted to fight back with this knife, but only managed to slice through the attacker's hair. Match. Mr. Vale owned an oil and heating company.
Looking it up now. Yes, he's got a sizable warehouse in the industrial district and a fleet of delivery trucks.
And now Vicky's got it.
What exactly happened in that house?
I think I know. After we stopped her at the rail station, Vicky needed a place to hide her supply of drugs. Her father's trucks and warehouse offered the perfect cover. To do that, she needed them out of the way. With Vicky Vale fully assuming her new identity of Lady Arkham, seems like she didn't need the Vales around to support her old one. Vicky showed up to attack her adopted parents, but only the mother was there at first. Miss Vale fought back and was able to slice off part of Vicky's hair. Vicky then subdued her with the same drug she used on me, but a much, much larger dose, nearly lethal. She then removed the mother's eyes, indicating a deeply personal motivation. This was obviously some sort of vendetta. Sometime during this, Mr. Vale entered. Vicky attacked him with his own belt, striking with the buckle until he was unconscious and bleeding out. Finally, she dragged him to the closet and hung him with the belt. The blood loss got him way before the hanging did.
Well, that's horrific! She never acted out in such a violent way before. Why would she-
Alfred, I think someone's still in the house. Going to look for a heat signature. If anyone else is here, I'll find them. Clear. Nothing here.
Anything?
No. There's someone here, under the stairs, alive. It's okay. I'm not going to hurt you.
Sir, is everything all right?
It's a kid, Alfred. The boy from the photo.
Is he all right?
Aside from the shock and a few bruises, he seems okay. He might be able to tell me more about what happened.
Possibly. But if that's the road you go down, please do it with caution.
How about you come on out?
No! No! Go away!
I'm sorry I scared you. It's going to be okay.
Yeah?
I need you to tell me if you saw or heard anything. This is important.
I heard someone say something. Something about drugs, fighting the police. I don't know who. I don't know who because I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything because I hid in here. Please don't send me to punishment.
Calm down. See, that does help me. Thank you.
Get down!
Trying to figure out our next move. Figure out where the drugs are. Did I get it? Am I close? Pathetic. I've got these little back traps all over the city, but I should have known a good double murder would be what brought you out in the open.
Nice work, kid.
They're dead.
Yes, they are. But you're not. You're still alive. And those emotions you're feeling, someday you'll learn how to use them. To channel them. You might not understand now, but someday it will make you stronger. I promise, I won't stop until I catch the person that did this. You're the kid who saved Batman, and no matter what happens, no matter where you go, that will always be true. And I will always owe you one.
Batman!
Oh my God.
He was the only survivor.
Come on, let's get you out of here.
He saved me.
Oh, Jesus. Was this the Children of Arkham? Again? Why would they attack a family like the Vales?
Because their daughter, Vicky, is Lady Arkham. She killed her own parents so she could use their company warehouse to stockpile the rest of her drugs.
Vicky? Vicky Vale, the reporter? And so, who was the boy then?
My guess is he's another foster child living with the Vales. He says he heard something about drugs and attacking the police. Can't confirm anything, but it sounds like the Children of Arkham might be plotting something with those drugs against your people.
Thanks for the heads up.
The warehouse is Vale Oil and Heating. You should secure it as soon as possible.
I'll get on it right away. What about you?
I've got something I need to look into.
Lieutenant, what's going on here?
Securing the crime scene, Commissioner.
Not anymore, you're not. I'm taking over this investigation. I can't risk you allowing Batman to contaminate our crime scene again.
So your bat stunner just didn't work?
That's right. I have a bad feeling it was no accident.
Alfred, get Lucius on the line for me, please.
Of course.
Let's get a closer look at you. No damage on the microfiber. Adhesion regulation reads normal. EMP functionality is all in the green. It should have worked. Electricity conductor, everything looks functional. This doesn't make any sense. This is strange. This microchip is emitting a low bandwidth receiving signal, but it shouldn't be.
Like the ones you shut down in the GCPD.
Something like that. But Lucius had his eyes on the Wayne tech that the Children of Arkham breached. This is something different.
Bruce, I have Lucius on screen now.
Good evening, Bruce. How can I help?
I need you to see something. Sending you schematics.
God, someone's found a way to get past my security upgrades.
Not just someone. Oswald Cobblepot.
Bruce, I am so sorry. I should have caught this, but he snuck right under my nose. Oh, what a mess. But that sleaze Cobblepot at the heart of it all.
Don't waste time beating yourself up about it, Lucius. Let's just focus on fixing it.
Right, right. Looks to me like he's introduced some sort of bug into your network.
That's how he's making my equipment malfunction?
For now. But if he keeps it up, he could completely take control of your tech.
My lord, that would be catastrophic.
Is there anything you can do?
I can try to work on your firewalls. But if I do anything too drastic, he'll know we're onto him.
I'm tired of being on the defensive. Why don't we attack him instead?
I'm not sure, but I can certainly see what I can do.
Thanks, Lucius.
Bruce, you're going to want to see this.
Excuse us, Lucius.
Of course. Reports of Children of Arkham activity are down. But these efforts do not come cheap. That's why I am formally seizing the Wayne estate, so the corrupt wealth of Gotham's elite can go to the better purpose of protecting Gotham's common man. Mr. Wayne has 24 hours to evacuate his property and turn it over to the city, or he will be removed.
You can't let that egomaniac throw us out on the street.
I have to talk to him.
After what happened at the debate, Harvey probably isn't the biggest fan of Batman. On the other hand, perhaps Bruce Wayne can appeal to him on a more personal level.
Harvey's behavior is unpredictable. Random. Who knows how he will react either way?
Tonight, Batman saves Bruce Wayne.
Yes, about bloody time.
Screw this up, Harvey. It was the right thing to do.
Yeah, of course. Of course it was the right thing to do.
I just can't second guess myself.
Dangerous place to stand. Be so easy to slip and fall.
Oh, Batman.
What a surprise to see you on my roof.
You've gone too far. Leave Wayne alone.
Wayne? What, is this about the whole seizing his assets thing?
What are you gonna do? You gonna break my legs? Or maybe you're just gonna make threats. Words out that you don't get violent unless you have to.
Calm down, Dent. I just wanna talk.
Oh, really? A guy like you seems like he doesn't do a whole lot of just talking. Funny. Would have thought that this Wayne situation would be a little beneath you, Batman. After everything Bruce has done, Why should I do anything for him?
You're losing your mind, and everyone can see it, Dent.
You want to save me?
I protect everyone.
Oh, is that so? Wayne is just another curveball this stupid city threw my way. Hill and his goons, the Waynes, the children of Arkham. I'm finally starting to understand, to see just how sick Gotham really is. To save Gotham, I need to do some bad before it gets better.
Ready to go.
Do it. What did you do? Our Lady Arkham's drugs destroyed.
Man, we lost a bunch of our own guys. The apartment next door. Jesus Christ. Oh, man. That blast was way bigger than you said. We must have taken out a whole city block with it.
We stopped the children of Arkham. That's all that matters. That's what a leader does. I feel like I should thank you, seeing as you did give Gordon that tip.
Doing this, you're no better than the children of Arkham. You're worse.
No, I'm saving Gotham.
I doubt the police would see it that way.
The police? Oh, the smart ones already answer to me. Otherwise, well, I think Gordon is already a perfect example of what happens to the not-so-smart ones. Bet he wishes he had just handed over the location of the drug stockpile when I asked.
What did you say about Gordon?
Where is he? Getting what's coming to him. You're so full of big scary talk. If you want to save this city, this is how you have to do it.
Gordon is on our side. He's fighting for Gotham, too.
Crime Alley. They took him to Crime Alley. Back off of Wayne, huh? Let's take a ride, gentlemen.
What the hell is this?
Mayor Dent says you're getting in the way of protecting the city.
Dent's got you brainwashed.
No! He's trying to help! The children of Arkham are out of control, and no one is...
Batman! What a mess. Thank you,
Save
Batman.
The thanks, and explain to me why I just watched half a city block go up in flames. Dent took out the warehouse with the drugs, the location that I gave to you.
Are you accusing me of something, Batman? Just say it. Come on! Let's hear it!
I only told you. Dent knows, so someone you talked to told him.
You know we're on the same team here. So stop leaning on me and let's figure out what happened.
Tell me what you know.
By the time I got back to the precinct, Dent already had the information. He strong-armed it out of Commissioner Grogan. I didn't even have time to scratch my ass before I got hauled out here.
Dent's position makes him dangerous. He's persuasive and he has power.
Dent thinks that what he's doing is best for Gotham. Execution and martial law.
I know.
I always considered him my friend, but he's past saving. There's no world in which he manages to set this right.
I don't believe that. Everyone can be saved. You said it yourself. He's trying to help Gotham. He's just lost.
He's little more than lost. He's off the rails. I mean, you have to see that. We have a lot of work to do. Everything is such a goddamn mess. But
We gotta start somewhere.
You know your officers, Jim. Take the people you trust and start hobbling Dent's army. Get your precinct back.
You make it sound easy.
No, it won't be. But if anyone can do it, it's you. You're trusted.
Yeah. Gotta handle this first, though.
We will get through this, Jim.
I'm glad we're on the same side.
He's causing the feedback loop. He's somehow connected a black box computer to your encrypted network. God, it's like a digital battering ram. If he keeps this up, he could smash through the Batcave firewalls at any minute.
He'd have access to the Bat computer. Hang on, Lucius. It's Alfred. I'm patching him in. Al, Lucius figured out how Penguin's cracking my security. He has a device that...
I'm afraid we have another problem to deal with. Mr. Dent is pulling up to the manor as we speak, and he's not alone.
Already?
Sir, are you all right?
Penguin's hacking assaults are getting worse. At this rate, he'll have my tech compromised by the end of the night. Only place he could be hacking me from is Wayne Enterprises.
Well, I don't envy your position. Even Batman can't be in two places at once.
I need to stop Penguin. You go to the Batcave and make sure Harvey doesn't find it.
I understand.
Time to go to work. Lucius, are you there?
I'm off site, but I've tapped into the security systems to give us an advantage. I can let you know where Oswald's guards are, and which routes are clear.
So long as you can confirm Penguin's black box when we're in the lab.
I can do that too. Avoid that hallway. More guards ahead. Go right. Wait. Drones ahead. Turn around. Head for the elevator. I'm opening the doors. Now! Opening the doors now. Nice work.
I assume Oswald is in my office.
Naturally.
Damn it! Damn it! Damn it!
Does anyone have him? Useless! You're all bloody useless!
Hey! It's the Bat!
You're a dead man!
Well, if it ain't the biggest bleeding pleasure to see your sour mug again!
Gloat while you can, Cobblepot. I'm taking you down.
Yeah? I don't think so. In fact, I think it's you who's gonna get beat by me. I'm pretty good in a fight, you know. Been in a few scuffles here and there.
You seem pretty confident about that.
Yeah, well, I am. You know, I like your style, Batman. I really do. But you're really starting to be a pain in the ass. The children of Arkham are going to walk all over this city, and there isn't anyone who can stop us! Not even you! But this company under my expert stewardship. With the technology being developed, we could control nations.
Spare me the chatter, Cobblepot.
Afraid not, mate. This has been in the making for a long, long time. You know, Wayne was thinking too small. He was only tinkering around. So focused on consumer technology. Lady Arkham, she had vision. Oh, I see. It helps you plan things out ahead of time. Neat trick, though. Pretty flashy for someone who only wears black.
How?
Not just for fashion. It's very functional. Face it, Batman. You're outmatched. Without your tech, you're just a man in a pointy-eared costume. You can't stop us.
Watch me.
Come on, Batman! Show me what you got. My turn. You're pathetic! That little beaut is almost done hacking your precious network.
That's the device.
Few more minutes, or your secrets are mine.
I will stop you before that happens.
Is this how it feels when you put on that suit? I like it.
You learned yet?
I've shut you down. I'm the one with the toys now, Batman. This is the start of a new legacy, and I'm afraid you don't have any place in it.
It didn't have to be like this, Oswald. You should have given up when you had the chance.
Give up? Oh, I've already won. Now you can do whatever you want to me, but Lady Arkham's plans are already in motion.
Where is she? What is she planning?
The message is the same as it's ever been. We will open your eyes! This city's hypocrisy will be exposed!
Tell me where to find her.
Piss off! I'm not telling you anything.
You're nothing but a pawn to her. And you're a fool if you think otherwise.
You don't get it, do you? I'm not a pawn. I'm a soldier. I'd die before I sell out the cause.
What the?
Just cut me down, mate.
Sorry. Was this really necessary? I mean, what will people say?
Just tell him Wayne put up a fight.